On August 17, something special happened. For the first time, we detected gravitational waves that were coming not from the collision of black holes, but from the collision of two neutron stars. A neutron star is what's left after a star burns all of its fuel and implodes under its own weight. 135 million years ago, in a galaxy far, far away called NGC 4993, two neutron stars were in spiraling, they were rotating around each other. They got as close as the distance between Atlanta and Nashville when they started merging. As they were spiraling faster and faster, they were stretching and squeezing space-time. They produced a gravitational wave signal that kept traveling all the way to us, and then they merged. As they merged, they produced a fireball of gamma radiation. That light also traveled all the way to us. And the residual matter that was left behind started merging in nuclear reactions in this process that's called a kilonova, and they produce heavy elements such as iron and gold. The gravitational waves reached the two LIGO detectors and the Virgo detector. They produce almost imperceptible changes in the length of the three detectors. And that was detected as a gravitational wave signal by LIGO and Virgo. About 2 seconds after the gravitational waves arrived to LIGO and Virgo, the Fermi satellites detected a burst of gamma radiation that was coming from an area of the sky that was consistent with the gravitational waves. Within about 40 minutes, telescopes and satellites all over the world were alerted of this event, and they started their follow-up campaign. And this is going to give us important clues in where heavy elements are formed, how matter, as we know, is formed, in which processes. And this is very exciting because we are really making use of both the gravitational wave and the electromagnetic wave information to learn new things. We have really unlocked this new window into the universe, and we're making the best use possible of it.